Welcome, this is the RPA Champion, and in today's video, we are going to be learning something really amazing. We are going to be building from scratch a receipt processing process. In a few words, what we are going to build is we are going to have a folder with all of our receipts, different receipts from different restaurants, bookshop, a newsstand, a coffee place. We're going to put all of our receipts in one folder. We're going to put this folder online, and then we're going to create a machine learning algorithm that is going to extract the receipts, is going to scan the receipts, is going to extract the information from the receipts, information such as amount, total, item purchase, date of the receipts. So we will be using this pre-configured machine learning model that is already available in Power Automate, in AI Builder. And this will incredibly boost our speed for creating this process. So we're going to use this plugin. Just to give you an example, I will upload a receipt and we will see what results do we get. So I will upload this example receipt and we will see how well this model has been trained. So it has identified already a lot of information on this receipt. It has identified different items, the total, the price of each one of the items. And additionally, it has also identified different dates, the merchant phone number and the merchant name. So, all right, we have a model. Now let's integrate it in our flow and let's create an automatic process. Great. We're not going to click on using app or using flow. We're going to create it from scratch. So we're going to go to create and we can create a automatic flow, meaning a flow where every time we upload a file into a specific folder or we receive an email with our invoice, we will trigger this process. But right now, just to show you how it works, I will trigger the process manually. So I will call this bill check. Bill check extract. So the first thing that we need to do is we need to get to our invoices. So I have already created a folder on my Google Drive where I have put a couple of different invoices. And to show you kind of what the invoices look like, every invoice is a little bit different. Every invoice has something different from the previous, so that they're all different use cases and they will all test the pre-built model in a different way. There is also invoices with different languages with handwritten text on them that are a little bit wrinkled. So there is really, I've tried to get quite a few different use cases and see how accurately it would act. All right, so we have a folder on our Google Drive. Now, what we need to do is we need to extract the information from that folder. So let's go to our Drive folder. And let's list all of the files inside of this folder. So let me access Google Drive. You should sign in with the account that you want to use. And let's go into this. Perfect. So we'll list the items inside of the bills folder. So let's do this one more time. There we go. Now that we have listed all of the files inside of our folder, now we need to access each one of these files. So let's take Google Drive again and let's get the file. So let's get the file content using the ID. Perfect. So we know that we've listed all of the files. Now we have the different information regarding the files. So we can now list the different files with the ID. Now, when we click the ID, the apply to each is going to create. Why? Because there is more than one invoice or there's more than one file inside of our folder. So we're going to do this for every single file. Now, inside of this loop, we're going to add the next step. The next step is going to extract the information from our invoice. So now that we have our invoice here, let's use the AI Builder and let's look for the pre-build skills, process and save information from receipt. So this is the pre-build skills that we were using before. Now here, we need to put the invoice. So let's find the invoice. We can use directly the file content. Now we are putting the file content inside the processing and this will process the result. So this will extract the data from the invoice. Now, the next step that we need to do is we need to insert this information somewhere, in an Excel sheet, in an email. Maybe we could have even an approval process where it says that if the amount of an invoice is larger than a total amount, we would do certain steps. So in this example, I have created a simple Excel file where we're going to store just some random information to extract from the invoice, such as receipt number, or how about we call it merchant name, date, item, price, and total. So every invoice, I believe, is going to have different items, is going to have a total. So these are all different kinds, different information. So now let's start extracting the data from our invoices, and let's start automating this process. Now we have the Excel that is ready. Let's go back into our process and let's add a new row inside of our Google Sheet / Excel. So let's look for sheets. Here it is, Google Sheet. What we need to do is we need to insert a row. All right, so we pick a file, and the file I have created is called Invoice. And once we select the sheet, automatically we are going to see the fields that we have created, such as merchant name, date, item, price, and total. So for the merchant name, we click on it, we automatically see the different fields that are extracted or understood or trained in the model. So merchant name, do we have the date? Purchase item price, purchase item quantity, let's look for the date, transaction date, perfect. The total, I have just seen the total as well. And then we need the price of the item. So let's see if we can purchase item price and purchase item name. So we need one more, which is the purchase item name. And this would already kind of extract a lot of information and should start showing up here as soon as we trigger our process. Very well. This is pretty much everything that we have to do in this basic version. Now the next thing that is left for us is to save it and test it. And just imagine if this works. If this works, we could save loads, many hours of time spent extracting boring information from receipts and copying it into whatever application or Excel file for our purposes. So I'm testing the flow. Fingers crossed that this is going to work on the first try. Let's run the flow and see what happens. So we have triggered the flow. We have extracted all of the files. Now it's applied to each. It's running 6 seconds. We should already be seeing some invoices. And here we have it. It's already starting to extract the different data. So for example, some information it is not able to extract, some information it is able to extract, not from all invoices. As I was showing you previously, every invoice in that I was using there has a different kind of layout, different conditions to make it fail. So with this one, I was trying to get a little bit of a mixture of all kinds of different invoices, and we see kind of what is the information that we can extract. So we can extract the total from almost every single invoice. We can extract the item from every single invoice. We can extract also the merchant name from the majority of the invoices, and also the date the invoice was created. So just in a matter of few seconds, I believe that this flow is still processing. Yes, the flow is still processing. In a matter of few seconds, we have analyzed dozens of different invoices. 12 different invoices with many different items on the invoices, and have saved us a lot of time instead of doing this manually. So let's just give this a couple of more seconds to complete and see the final output, and also the final time that it takes for us not only to complete the process, but also to check and make sure that everything is correct. So the process has completed. Let's go to our invoice, and we can see all of the information that was inserted from our invoice. So let's maybe open one of the invoices and see what is the information that was completed. So maybe let's try to find this one, And this one is for a British cafe. So I believe British cafe is right here. It was not able to identify the $4 from the bill. However, it was able to identify different items inside of the bill. Now let's try another one. Let's try this Temple Bar one. So Temple Bar, $14. Now if we go here and we try to find for Temple Bar, here we have it. Temple Bar, there's probably two receipts for Temple Bar. Let's check details of this. $665, $502. So we'll go back to our bills and just check out what missing information we would have to fill out. So this is also due to the poor quality of some of the invoices that I have received. So for those invoices, I would probably have to manually go inside and insert the missing information. However, the majority of the information has been inserted and is still allowing me to save some time. Now we have completed this process, a baseline process, just kind of a draft process on which you can work and add new features like an approval workflow or an email notification or a control or a check. But this is just basic approval workflow to extract information from receipts. We were able to create it, deploy it, and be able to utilize it in less than 10 minutes. So I really encourage you and invite you to go check it out for yourself, to automate the processes in your company, to help out your colleagues by automating and speeding up these repetitive manual tasks. Thank you so much for watching. It's been great. I really hope you enjoyed this video. If you have any ideas or suggestions for what kind of content and videos you would like to watch, leave me a suggestion in the messages below. Don't forget to subscribe, give me a thumbs up, and I will see you in the next video.